Welcome to a recap of tutorial number 2. This video recap is going to answer the 3 questions that were kind of the driving focus of that second tutorial. Question number 1, what exactly does RTI mean? How do we define it? Question number 2, what are the core principles that all RTI models should contain? And the final question, what are those RTI facts? How do I distinguish between the RTI facts and the myths? Let's get started. So, I'm going to put a prompt on the screen, and I want you to read the prompt. For example, the prompt is, define RTI in your own words. Go ahead and pause the video, take a few seconds reflecting on this prompt, and then come back, play the video, and compare your response to the one shown on the screen. So how do we define RTI again? It's a systematic process that ensures all students in a school have opportunities to make themselves better. Remember, it's all students and a systematic process. It involves everybody. Okay, what are those 5 core principles again related to RTI? The first principle is extremely important. In the old days, schools would wait for students to fail before they intervene. However, the current research says we need to be proactive, not reactive. The second core principle, we need to get to the root cause. In order to address the student's problem, you need to know what's causing it. Third principle, make data-informed decisions. Fourth principle, best first instruction. And the final principle, again, is a systems-level school approach. Those are the 5 core principles that all RTI models contain. Now, teaching is very complex, and even the best teachers with the best differentiated instruction can't reach all students. Some students are going to still fall through the cracks. And guess what? This is okay. Some learners just need more time and support to reach mastery. And this time and support is achieved through an RTI model. So those students aren't going to fall through the cracks. They're going to be saved. Why are they going to be saved? Well, because of those core principles that we just looked at. An RTI system is going to require, not give students a choice, we're going to make you receive extra instruction according to your need. And this will prevent future student struggles. So instead of that student falling through the cracks and being unhappy, because an RTI system is in place, that student's need should now be addressed. Okay, RTI myths versus fact. True or false? RTI is primarily a special education initiative. Think about it for a second. That is definitely false. Although it's got its roots out of special education, it quickly transferred into a general education initiative. Debunking RTI myths. True or false? RTI is a program that schools implement. That is definitely false. RTI is a framework that contains multiple levels of support that concurrently connect all the school's programs, such as curriculum mapping, common assessments, and professional learning communities. True or false? The primary focus of RTI involves interventions. Again, definitely false. Although interventions play a primary role in RTI, the most important part of RTI is best first instruction. We want to limit the number of students that need interventions. So, in closing, we know that in every class we have, no 2 students are alike. There's such vast diversity in every classroom. Because of that, we need to use different tools for each student to ensure all students achieve our intended learning outcomes. Bottom line, simply put, RTI is what's best for kids.